In humble huts all across the archipelago, important work is taking place. It is the work of teachers and students coming together to preserve tradition, blending the ancient knowledge with engaging teaching methods, enlivening for a younger audience the ways of the past, or simply bringing communities together to judge what is valuable, what must be taken on the journey forward. In this season of Dayaw, we visit the schools of living traditions to listen to the voices of those who have made it their mission to preserve cultures, to see in the eyes of the young a world that they will gladly inherit, preserve, and pass on.
This is what it means to be Sisidlan, a bearer of culture, a school for living traditions. The word champion evokes images of great achievements in sports, in academics, in pop culture. Champions are, to our minds, often young and brave, committed and daring. In this episode of Dayaw, we invite you to expand your definition of the word to include propagators of the traditional arts. In this case, a woman, a weaver of mats. Not young at all, but brave, committed, and daring enough to become a recipient of the Gawad sa Manlilikha ng Bayan. The champion's name is Estelita Bantilan. She is 78 years old. She is proudly Balan. To trace the story of this Gamaba champion is to know the story of the Balan people, indigenous Filipinos of southern Mindanao. Like many of the animist Lumad of Mindanao, the Balaan were hunters, Sweden farmers, and foragers who once occupied the vast plains known as Colondatal, present-day Coronadal. Linguists and scholars trace the name of the group to two words, Bala and An, meaning an opponent people. Whose opponents they were is not exactly sure, as the culture of the Balaan is closely related to other neighboring animist groups like the Bagobo and the Tiboli. All these southern Cotabato people share many traditions in agriculture, social structures, material culture, and political leadership. In their rituals, their chants and dances, the Balaan reaffirm their close ties with the environment and the great creator, Maludvata. It is to the great creator that the Balaan people owe their existence, their lives intertwined with those of all living things, as well as the spirits of nature, who are a very real living presence in traditional Balaan communities. It is one class of spirits, the Inilong, who guides the weavers of a Balaan specialty, the Abaka Ikat. Like the Tiboli, Bagobo, Mandaya, and Subanon, the weaving of Abaka Ikat is a specialty and point of pride for the Balaan. Another Balaan weaver, Bayabing Masalondulo,
was also awarded the Gamaba Distinction together with Estelita.
Estelita Bantilan, manghahabin ng igen.
Masaya po daw siya, ma'am, nung nalaman niya na isa siyang nanomine. Napakasaya daw niya, ma'am, na naging ano siya, Gamaba siya.
But Estelita is different. Her specialty is igen, the weaving of mats. Mats were both utilitarian as well as sacred objects for the Balaan. They were used for sleeping and resting and as protective layered wraps for clothes and textiles. But the igem were also used in rituals that communicated with the spirits. When laid out on the floors and sat upon by shamans and healers, the mat became a means by which sacred spaces were denoted. Into these protected spaces, the spirits could freely enter, their desires, advice, and healing communicated through the mediums. The nature of these mats places Estelita in a distinct space shared with all the Gamaba winners. As creators of objects that had both sacred and utilitarian function, as bearers of a traditional craft that was necessary for both everyday life and ritual functions. Malapatan in Sarangani is home to this complex Balaan universe, where nature, the spirits, and man coexist to this day.
This program is brought to you by Emirates. Fly Emirates. Fly better.
Estelita is considered the matriarch of her clan. Thus, her art is informed with the wisdom of generations. The matriarchs who came before her, as well as a present crop of younger family members who share her pride of the Gamaba distinction.
She was not always Estelita to the community. As a child, she was named Labnai and grew up in a traditional Balaan community. But the coming of Protestant pastors in the 1950s introduced many social and spiritual changes into the community. Thus, Labnai was baptized and on her marriage became Mrs. Tuada Bantilan. Like many of her generation, she has raised her family in the faith of the pastors. But what remained of the traditional Balaan animism, she has kept on in her work as a weaver of mats. It is a task that she has devoted her life to. Unlike many other Balaan women who must tend to farm and family and otherwise seek alternative means of livelihood. But Tuwada, her husband, was very supportive of her passion for mat weaving. Thus, despite tending to other needs of her family, she was given ample time to master her art. The pandanus romblon is a material for many mat weaving traditions all over the Philippines. The gathering, treatment, and preparation of the raw materials is a process also shared by Philippine mat weavers.
Paano niyo siya ginagawa hanggang sa finished product?
Pag-harvest ng romblon, mag-harvest niya ng romblon, tapos kunin yung buto niya, tapos i-dry sa sun-dry 3 days para matuyo. Tapos pagkatapos, i-roll siya.
Nakakulog mo naman doon, kafag.
Ano po muna yung tawag niyo sa pag-harvest?
Kamlang, Luis, kamlang.
Marian Pastoroses wrote of the weaving process so eloquently in her introduction to Estelita's art. Much of her insights bear quoting here as we see Estelita at work.
Kalaki yung nagawa niya, tapos ilang araw niya ginawa yun?
6 feet ang lapad, tapos 9 feet ang haba.
Tapos ano yung una niyang design na nagawa?
Yung design na, ma'am, yung parang magsalom ka sa tubig.
May malapit po ba kayo sa dagat?
Ito ang makikita nila, ma'am.
Tapos po, nung lumalaki na kayo, nakaisip ka na ba ng sarili mong design? Tapos paano niya naiisip yun?
Yay, kapag dam ko ni mong gulisa, hindi nawago.
Ang nagturo daw sa kanya, ma'am, na gumawa ng design, yung ano niya, yung sa isip niya, sa puso niya, yun ang tumuro sa kanya na yan ang gagawin niya ng design. Sa
taon, gulit kibo, kurun, design, kurun.
Pastor's words so deftly capture the very essence and spirit of traditional weavers. And Estelita is a worthy exemplar of both the serenity and dexterity that marks all true master weavers. Among the mat weavers of her community, Estelita has long been acknowledged as a master weaver. Her work noted for the tightness of the weave and the compelling mix of color and patterns. While many of the other weavers make mats with sellability in mind, Estelita still faithfully adheres to the motifs she learned as a child. But she is not averse to exploring new ways in which these designs can be introduced to a larger community.
What is the greatest responsibility of a Gamaba awardee? As a bearer of culture and tradition, the joyful challenge is to pass on the knowledge to ensure that a new generation will be there to carry the art into the future.
Naman nyo nung na-declare si Bay na isa sa mga bagong Gamaba awardee.
Si Mother, siya ang bilang naging natanggap bilang Gamaba Award at naging isang artist naman yan. Talagang masayang-masaya siya.
Proud din ako.
I-proud ko eh, Mother ko yan eh. At anak din niya ako eh. I-proud ko yan sa sarili ko na si Mother. Ayun pala. Siya nang nakatanggap na sa bisang bilang Gamaba Award.
Dahil sa kahirapan namin noon bilang farmer, ako po'y nag-aral sa city. Lahat ng ginawa niya, kahit yung sili na native, ginawa niya, kunin niya para sa aking pag-aaral upang patuloy ako sa pag-aaral doon sa city. Ang inspirasyon niya na ginawa sa akin, kaya ako po'y sumikap sa pag-aaral upang ako'y makatapos at maging modelo na naming kabataan dito sa Aperlasang.
Sa pitong anak niya, apat na babae ang marunong gumawa ng panig. Yung tatlong lalaki, hindi po.
Anong klaseng teacher siya?
Araw-araw, tinuturuan kami pag umaga na, tapos paggabi, gumawa na rin kami.
Estudyante ko na trogo.
Mga estudyante po daw niya, ma'am, ang tinuturuan. Six years old pa lang ako, palagi akong tumutulong gumawa ng banig. Pero sa ano lang, sa gitna lang, kasi hindi ko pa alam yung sa gilid niya. Tapos, palagi akong tumutulong kaye na gumagawa. At ngayon, gumagawa na ako tuloy ng tuloy. Dahil alam ko na kung gaano, kung paano gumawa ng banig. At yung anak ko din, tinuro ko din siyang gumawa.
One month and a half, pala member di Matt Webbing. Kaning gumawa ng ano, damit, taon, board dance. Estelita, medyo may pakastrict kamay, pero sa tamang pamaraan.
Tinitingnan ko lang po yung gawa ni Donna. Minsan kasi po, kumukuha ko ng ano niya, yung mga gamit niya. Tapos, ganun, inaano ko. Gumagawa na rin ako ng sarili ko, ano, bani. Kina-check ko po muna sa kanya bago ko ipagpatuloy yung bani. Sa lahat ng matatanda dito na nag-release, siya lang po ang para ano, para ma-preserve po yung ano, pag-use ng bani. I-encourage ko po yung mga maliliit na bata. Kaya sa pamangkin ko, ngayon po, nag-start na rin po siya magawa ng bani.
Yes, naman, huri ka ngayon.
Isuporta sa kanya na para ipagpatuloy itong paggawa ng bani. Lalo na siya ang isang Gamaba Award na at isang artist na itong pag-advise sa kanya na tuturuin pa kahit yung mga anak o mga relatives para itong itong mat weaving na to hindi mawalan sa aming tribo bilang mga lumang nalitigaan.
Hindi lang dito sa Apalasang, kundi sa lahat ng mga blaan na kailangan matuto silang mag-quit ng banig.
Patuloy tayong gumawa ng banig kasi para hindi mawala ang tradisyon at para matuloy sa mga bagong kabataan ngayon, para hindi mawala ang tradisyon namin na gumawa ng banig.
Allow us once more to quote from Marian Pastoros's keen observations on Estelita's work and character.
Are among the best when it comes to weaving, not only the cloth but the mats that they have in this country. If you look at the mats woven by Estelita Bantilan, who is a Bilaan, no, you really will admire the very fine, all this micro detail of the patterns that she makes. When you pass your hand on the surface of the mats that she makes, you will feel that it's almost like cloth because of its fineness. We don't know of any other person who does it as fine as she does it. And hopefully with this award, we will be able to inspire young people. She will be able to inspire young people in her community. The importance in preserving the tradition of your own ethnic community. Otherwise, what's the point of being Bilaan if you cannot show anything that is Bilaan in identity? So this is really the importance of the work of Estelita Bantilan.
Yes, to alibun, batongi bulul, to alibun, italam yuk of yurekanun. Yes, balu, banuri, mulu, tini kato magal yuris yam dufu.
Yeah,
to always be a part and a reflection of a community's beliefs and aspirations. To put the self in service of that community while maintaining one's own standards and continually striving for excellence. Surely, many contemporary artists, whatever fields they've chosen to work in, can learn from Estelita's humility, her connectedness, her sense of belonging, and serving her people. More than skill, more than genius, these are the very qualities that make one a rightful bearer of Dayaw, our knowledge, our pride.
Together,